In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create an animated neon effect for logos, text, or any kind of shape layers in After Effects. So let's get to the video. First, I'm going to create a new composition. Name it render. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, 10 seconds for the duration. Click OK. Then drag the logo to the timeline. I'll be using the transparent Instagram logo as an example. Press S on the keyboard in order to adjust the scale of the logo if needed. I'll slightly increase mine so it is nicely in the center of the composition. After you've adjusted the scale and the position of the logo, right-click on it and select Pre-compose. Let's call this one Logo and make sure Move All Attributes is checked, then click OK. Now, while the logo composition is highlighted, go up to the layer and select Auto Trace. Here you can see the settings that I'm using to trace the outlines of the logo, so if you have preview on, you can see exactly what you're dealing with here. So click OK. Now I'm going to press U on the keyboard to reveal the masks that have been created, and we also have the mask path keyframes for each mask that we do not need to see. That's why I'm going to drag and select the keyframes and press delete to delete them. That'll make it easier for us to manage the keyframes for the future steps. Now, I'm going to open effects and presets window and search for saber, then add saber to the logo composition. That's how saber looks by default. I'm going to head over to the effect controls, expand customize core settings, and set core type to layer masks. As we do that, the saber is applied to the mask layers that we've created earlier. And I'm also going to expand the render settings and set composite settings to transparent, just to get the transparent background. I'm going to scroll all the way up, choose the presets dropdown, and here you have many different ones available. In this tutorial, we're focusing on the neon look. That's why I'm going to select the neon preset, and that gives us a very nice neon to begin with. But it might be a bit intense to in some of the areas. That's why you could drop the glow intensity to maybe 60%, and you can see that looks a lot better in my opinion. I'm going to move the time indicator to the start of the timeline. I'll create keyframes for mask evolution under the customized core settings and also for the end offset. I'll press U on the keyboard to see the keyframes on the timeline. Set end offset to 0%. Then I'll move 2 seconds forward. Set end offset to 51%, so it is animated halfway. Then I'll move past 2 seconds to maybe 6 seconds. And set mask evolution to 1 full cycle, and this will animate the saber throughout the composition. Now I'll select the logo comp, go into edit and select duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. Now I'll press U to see the keyframes on both of the layers. I'll move to the start to the first mask evolution keyframe and set the angle to 180 degrees. I'll move to the end keyframe of the mask evolution and set mask evolution to 180 degrees as well. And now we have two saber layers, and they are nicely stacked on top of each other. But we get this weird coloring issue here. That's because we need to change the modes of them to screen. I'm going to click toggle switches on modes until you see the modes column. Select both layers and set the mode of them to screen. And that fixes the coloring issue. Now we can change the color of each saber layer. I'm going to select the top logo layer, go into the saber settings, and set glow color to this bright blue, like that. And that makes the scene a lot more interesting in my opinion. So we can do the preview here. Here you can see we get the stroke animation at the start and the path animation throughout the composition. But one thing I'd like to add here is the flicker animation. And you can easily do that with a built-in saber setting. So I'm going to select the bottom logo, go into the flicker settings, and set flicker intensity to 50%. And do the same with the other one. Select it, expand the flicker settings. Set flicker intensity to 50%. Now we can do the preview again. And that'll add a subtle flicker animation that'll nicely complement the whole neon theme. And as I've mentioned at the beginning, you can use this method not only for logos, but for the text or any kind of shape layer that you might want to create in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.